Yo guys, all my life, I was told programming was hard. It's only for the nerds. It takes so much maths. Your grades aren't good enough. But having programmed now for 13 years, I can confirm that all these assumptions are false. And that is why when YouTube recently approached me with the opportunity to create an entry-level programming course, I knew this was my opportunity to try and correct some of the misconceptions that I'm sure are still preventing average people like you from diving into the amazing world of programming. But first things first, we have to knock it off with this Hollywood dramatic feel. So, you want to learn to code. I mean, I don't blame you. Forbes ranks computer science as the second most valuable major to learn. Now, of course, you could just go to your school and learn how to program, or you could just learn how to program from a dunce like me that has no traditional schooling background. Wait, hold on. Before you click off this video and sign up for a course at your local university, let me at least try and win your hearts with a quick story. Jeez. It all started when I was about 9 years old. My friend invited me over to play this new game that I had never heard about.
Yeah man, it's crazy. You get to play as Donkey Kong if you want, and fight against Link, Mario, and Pikachu.
And sure enough, he was talking about the original on the Nintendo 64. And like, I had always played video games. But there was something about this game that from that day on had me obsessed with video games. I remember when my family moved from Virginia to California in 2000. The whole drive across the US, I was designing my own Smash Bros. Levels using a little pen and notepad. And when Christmas came around, I asked my mother for a Nintendo 64 with Super Smash Bros. And I played that game for countless hours, absolutely captivated with the concept of it all. Iconic Nintendo mascots all together battling it out in a video game in three dimensions? How is something like this even possible? This whole experience is what got me interested in wanting to understand more about how video games work. No, not to learn how to program, because I was still at that age where I was still learning to read, write, and do basic maths. Again, it got me interested in wanting to learn how games work. And remember this, because this will become important later. It wasn't long after that until I came across a little website called Newgrounds.com, a place where people like me were making simple, low-budget games and interactive movies. And I believe this truly to be the experience that planted the seed in my head that making video games like the ones that I love playing was actually possible for someone like me. So, a little later in life when I came across something called Game Maker, which advertised itself as you can start making games today, no code required. And after weeks of begging my mother to buy it for me, she finally did. And man, that was such a fun time in my life. I had absolutely no idea what I was doing, but just doing the best that I could to create logical statements that would make a computer do what I wanted to do was enough to get me hooked. Feeling that sensation of being truly tired for the first time because I stayed up all night trying to understand how to create an inventory system is something that I'll never forget. From that day forward, I continued to learn as much as I could, asking all for help who were willing to help me, learning more and more, not about programming, but about how games work. Because you see, understanding how games work is what initially drew me to programming in the first place, and without even knowing it, that is what I would always fall back on when times got rough during my coding adventures. And so, moral of the story is, I know what it's like to have an extreme urge to learn this stuff, while being not exactly sure where to start. So, I know exactly what you're missing and how to get you on this side of the fence. And thankfully, I've learned how to do all this stuff without traditional schooling, which means you and I, we speak the same language, eh? Now, if that story didn't win over your heart, you probably don't have one. No, I'm just kidding. But I'm sure that this will. This here is my friend Zarglar. Zarglar is a highly intelligent programmer that has, no joke, programmed literal entire star systems solo, using only a TI-80 calculator. And when I told Zarglar I was going to be making a programming course, he would not shut up about wanting to teach it for me. Now, Zarglar is a quintillion times smarter than I am. But why do you not want Zarglar to teach this course? Well, watch this. Zarglar, what is an array?
Well, you see, we need a bit of a backstory, because traditionally, memory can only store information at a 32-bit rate, which made recursion difficult to pull off. But when Moore's Law gained traction in 1996, we not only attained more power and memory use.
Okay, Zark, you've proved my point. This audience didn't understand any of that PhD programming slang, mate. It's time to go. And next time, remember to breathe.
Aw, man.
So, welcome to my course. In this series, you will leave with everything you need to start programming. Yes, you've read the title right. This is not clickbait. In fact, by the end of this course, you will write your very first application utilizing everything that we learned. But if you are to remember anything from this course, please let it be this. Ask yourself, why are you here? What has drove you to want to learn everything you need to start programming? Again, for me, it was to understand how games work. Whatever your reason may be, I encourage you to write that reason in the comment section now. And if at any point throughout this course, or hell, throughout anywhere in your programming adventures, things get tough, I want you to return to that comment to be reminded on the reason why you started. Trust me, you got this. I promise it's a lot easier than you think, and I'm gonna do the best I can on the communication side of things to make it even easier for you on this course. I will see you on the next part.